Ah, London. What a town. History around every corner, and a tourist photographing it. Pubs serving up a pint and a smile. All that music, theatre and art. And multiculturalism. And the world's oldest underground, the Tube. The class of cities, really. Top shelf stuff. Only took 12,000 years to build it up, and one night to tear it all down.
Our status.
Perimeter security's down, but plenty of your flying friends about.
Fucking hell.
Dalton, no time to waste.
Yes, ma'am. I'm in. Any idea what we're up against, Bagley?
If you haven't brushed off, I might. Ever consider leaving these security threats to the authorities?
That's rich, Bagley. The government would sooner arrest us for trying to help than actually do something useful.
We'll have to sort this one on our own.
Carefully, Dalton.
Bagley, are you detecting a little worry in Sabine's voice?
Brilliant. Asking the computer about feelings. This explains so much.
Shut it, you two, and get to work.
There she is.
Hello everybody, my name is Tubasplat, and welcome to Watch Dogs Legion. And I am recording this on a very different way. Instead of doing it just through Share Factory, I am recording this through
more than it hurt me.
My capture card, and subsequently on HitFilm Express
do us a favor,
editing
keep
software.
It quiet, Dalton.
If they don't shoot me, I won't shoot them. How's that?
So just as always, I'm trying not to talk over the the video, the audio. So yeah, this is a completely different way of me doing videos, and I'm very interested to see how it turns out. Yeah. So, we're at the beginning here of Watch Dogs Legion. I have already finished this game once, and I am very anxious to try it again, this time playing it a little differently. As we'll get to later on, that you get all sorts of different operatives to join your legion, except this time around I am not using permadeath like I did in my first playthrough, and then as well as I will have, each operative will have at least one flaw to them. So that's going to make this playthrough immediately more challenging, I think. Or I am anticipating, rather. So. Let's wait and see. And if you're wondering why it is so dark, it's because, again, during my first playthrough, I didn't like.
And why do you suppose that is?
Like, it didn't look great, in my opinion.
I don't know.
So I played around with the display settings. And I'm playing this on my alt account, so it's not quite exact. So I was just playing around with the display settings and trying to give it more contrast and darkness, and I gave it a little too much, but of course this being the opening mission is not the greatest way to start it, so.
The entire place is rigged to blow.
Jesus, those canisters. Bagley, is that...
RDX nitrogen. Enough to level Parliament.
Can you locate a detonator, Bagley?
Not exactly, but there's a device streaming a fuckload of encrypted data from the floor above you.
Yeah, that fits the bill. On my way.
Bagley's a great character. He's really funny.
Bagley, is that not the detonator?
No, but it's a transmitter sending a signal to a device on the floor above us. Safe to assume that would be the detonator we're looking for.
Yeah, I just keep doing the, I would say sensor, just to figure out where everyone is, so. Just go ahead and just pop, pop, pop. And I thought there was a space that I can get through, and not quite, so. Yeah, it's not too bad. I'm really kind of lost for words here because, again, normally I've got all this stuff, like, in fast-forward motion, but I'm still pretty unfamiliar with my editing software. But I'll have to play around and start to learn how to use it. So, things can be put to better use.
Propaganda all around the bombs. These pricks are going to blow up Parliament and hang it on us.
Not if you get to that detonator first.
And I think I'm going to have to disappear because there's going to be some cutscenes after this. Yes, there is. So I'll see you guys in the next bit.
Of Commons. Whoever these men in black are, they've got brass bollocks to set up in the center of government.
I found the detonator. And it's definitely live. Bagley, I'm gonna need some help with this.
Yes, you are, but sadly, I'm locked out.
Fuck. Well, we don't have a chance without Bagley.
Wait, I might know a workaround. We trained in manual overrides at MI5.
You're full of surprises.
Be quick about it.
All right, Bagley, do your thing.
I'm in. And the bombs have just armed themselves. Well, that may complicate matters.
Fuck's sake.
Can you defuse them or not?
Of course I can, but I might also trip another failsafe and vaporize you, so fair warning.
Expect this to draw some attention your way, Dalton.
Oh, I'm counting on it.
Company at our back door.
Shit. Dalton, we've got some heat here at HQ.
How long is this going to take, Bagley?
Depends how often you interrupt me with questions.
All right, everyone. Faces on, guns out. It's about to get real.
They're on me. I'll try and hold them off.
There gotta be some.
Clear. Let's keep looking.
So, yeah. Just trying to.
Bagley, update.
Let's just say I'm both impressed and annoyed by how sophisticated this anti-tamper security is. Still working. Aim assist.
Tell me you're close.
Overall, I
security
enjoy
now
this
wading
game.
Through terabytes of decoy code looking for the detonation sequence.
The first time I played it, I thoroughly enjoyed it. Permadeath, I guess I could talk about it now since I don't really have a whole lot going on. Permadeath for me was a little annoying. After a certain point, it just got to a point where it was just constantly, I was losing operatives in my first playthrough, and so permadeath became very annoying to me, which is why I have it turned off here, because I really don't want to experience it all again, so. That's that.
Problem, Dalton. I need your physical appendages now.
What's wrong?
There are three slots on the left. One of them is the receiver. You need to pull the controller wire.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm fucking not. Pull the wire.
If this gets me blown up...
Bombs defused.
See? That wasn't so bad, was it?
Bagley, you bastard. You nearly gave me a bloody heart attack then. Whoa, what the fuck am I looking at?
It appears Parliament is not the only target. More bombs are going live as we speak.
On screen, Bagley.
Fucking hell, we need to get the word out. Those sites need to be evacuated.
They're spread out all over London. There isn't any time.
But my sister's at the Tone Conference. We have to do something.
I picked up a transmitter on the roof that is sending out a signal to the other bomb sites. If you can reach it...
I can shut it all down. Sabine?
Fuck! Dalton, we're breached! Go! The roof!
Sabine, what's going on?
We're being raided. It's a bloodbath. Her protocol is to wipe everything, including Bagley.
I need him for the transmitter.
I know, but if they get him, they get everything. Names, ops, locations.
Okay, I'll do it the old-fashioned way. Wipe him.
Yes, wipe me.
Do it, Sabine, and get the hell out of there.
Fuck. Okay, Bagley's down. You're on your own. Dalton, if this goes...
He won't. I'll see you at the rally point. I promise.
Good luck.
Going to happen. You're here to help us with some important work.
Important work? Killing thousands of...
Exactly. To save the world. You do know Londoners have died before, hmm? The plague, the Great Fire, the Blitz. It's not much fun. But destruction is always the cure. And it begins today. 0 day. Time for a hard reset.
Oh my God.
Months ago, a series of explosions devastated 3 sites in London. Authorities are asking residents to remain in their homes as the situation continues to develop. We have received no official casualty total, but it is expected.
For a series of candlelight vigils that brought closure to thousands of families and indeed to an entire city. London is now laser-focused.
They attend Downing Street, where Nigel Cass, CEO of private military company Albion, received a mandate to secure London. Cass has vowed to hunt down DedSec. Terrorist group responses may have evolved. Albion used cutting-edge artificial intelligence systems and autonomous drones to capture the remaining members of DedSec. A stark warning to would-be insurgents.
Corporations are posting record profits due to increased efficiencies in production and distribution, enabled by the use of technologies initially developed and approved for security purposes.
A long overdue cleanup as crime numbers take a dive. Illegal gambling, drug trafficking and prostitution all down following prosecutions of the leaders of 4 of London's 5 largest criminal syndicates. The streets of Camden and Brixton.
Finding London mandate is extended indefinitely by the government, life finally begins to return to normal. Curfews and travel restrictions have been lifted in all boroughs, thanks to the deployment.
Big news outlets, reports of rioting in Trafalgar Square have been greatly exaggerated, possibly by foreign meddlers pushing a false narrative through social media. Albion is in complete control of a few...
...reprimand the public about the circulation of fake news, conspiracy theories persisting in dark corners of the internet, that terrorist group DedSec were framed for the bombings, have been roundly rejected. Our own reporters could not find a single Londoner willing to expound those theories on camera. The facts simply don't fit any other story.
I need to assemble a team, but I can't reboot DedSec alone. Let me break into London CTOS and see who's available.
So yeah, that's what happened. That DedSec got blamed for bombings in London.
We've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I say they should all be lined up and shut.
You don't find it awfully convenient that they've been fingered
again,
as the
attackers? Again, really trying not to talk
no
over the audio, but I mean, it's not total plot worthy. Like, it's
well,
not
Colin,
like, totally
to
worthy
look
of
look
the plot,
of
but
non-violent action. Albion's put more civilians in the hospital in the past few months than DedSec ever has. I smell a scapegoat.
But,
now I have Emily calling in.
Yeah,
Emily,
it's an interesting concept.
Absolutely right, Claire. The government's
with you,
just
so.
Framing DedSec because they want to make it seem
I've
like they
enjoyed
have
this game thoroughly,
control.
And I really want to,
no
again, play it again with a different
news,
set of eyes and experiences. So.
Who better to pin it on?
Angie, I have you next. What do you make of all this?
I think if anything, DedSec showed their true colors. It's terrifying to think we harbored such a dangerous element for years. Terrorists in our own backyard.
Do you find DedSec more frightening than the different gangs in London like Clan Kelly?
Clan Kelly might set your shop on fire and maybe they'd kill you, but even they wouldn't try to blow up all of Parliament.
Next, I have Crypto King. Do you feel safer using...
is worse than I thought. But there's a candidate. Looks like you're DedSec's best hope.
And so...
Glad to see you're alive. If you're still committed to the cause, DedSec needs you. I'll send you the coordinates to our last safe house. Meet me there.
Fine.
I was gonna say, now begins where... I'm, like, the only person not playing Cyberpunk 2077, and instead I'm playing Watch Dogs Legion. Again. I don't know about Cyberpunk. Like, I don't know, like, anything about it. Other than it's another game from CD Projekt Red, and that this game, that game was more or less developed for the next generation of systems, the Series X and the PlayStation 5, but, yeah, so, but anyway, as you can see, I did change the display settings back to normal, or like default, and it already does look a lot better than when I've had it at, so I think that's what I'll just continue to use, is default settings. So this is the first operative. It was her, and then another operative I was thinking about using first.
I've downloaded a patch to your optics so you can
the other one had
a
MP5 gun, so it was like a fully automatic.
You'll have to do the manual.
But then realizing that silence is key in this game, or at least just my personal preference, is stealth is key. So let's decide what I go with, because she has a crowbar. I think she has a crowbar because she's an artist.
Whoa.
Not that makes a difference.
This is so legit.
And then I'll try to like customize them and everything else. So
wait, wanker, we're clear. Get the power back.
Then no, this isn't default. I don't know. I may have screwed around with the settings again. I don't remember.
No DedSec registration detected. Identify yourself, or I'll seal the exits, hack your optic, and read you every drunken email you ever wrote until you starve.
Wait, calm down, mate. No need to get hostile. Sabine sent me.
Sabine's alive? Well, that's one piece of good news. I'm Bagley, DedSec's definitely not stolen, highly advanced AI assistant, and it seems I've been out of commission for a few months. Anyway, why don't you go connect me to the DedSec network so I can become more powerful than you could possibly imagine? I mean, catch up on what I missed.
And again, I was just like spinning the camera around just to really see what the display settings, like if they were too like better than what I was using before or not. So I think this is the default, so I'm gonna roll with that.
Ah, that's it. I'm reconnected to the network, downloading our database, news archives, and oh no. Terrorist group DedSec responsible for deadly bombings in London. Dalton Wolf dead? I leave you people alone for a second and you immediately cock it all up.
Bagley, who set up DedSec for the bombings?
There's a gap in my memory after Dalton, well, let's be honest, after I disarmed the bomb at Parliament. I'm missing information about what happened after I was taken offline. But from what I can infer, an unknown hacker group identified only as Zero Day was involved. I believe this Zero Day staged the attacks and framed DedSec for their dirty work. Come to my terminal. Sabine is requesting a video call.
Patching in Sabine Brandt now. I suggest you listen very closely to anything she has to say.
There you are. I'm glad you made it. Bagley. God, it's good to hear your demented little voice. Is your memory intact?
Not even slightly. The last record I have is of our HQ being raided. My only lead is a group known as Zero Day. Ring any bells?
No. But the HQ was attacked by some men in black, the same that were at Parliament. Maybe working together. We didn't stand a chance. They just gunned everyone down.
You're tougher than you look. Can't believe you're still alive.
I managed to escape through the sewers to Camden. A contact smuggled me out of the city, and I've been hiding out in the north since.
Prudent. Your profile is red flagged as a high priority target in the city's surveillance system. Even a partial recognition here would have you hunted down and shot on sight.
DedSec's rep is fucking trashed in London, even as anarchists go. If people were to ever find out I'm working with you...
Listen, if anyone knows anything about risks, it's me. I lost everything and everyone. But it comes down to this. London is in a death spiral. And if DedSec can't pull it out, trust me, no one can. The city needs a resistance. And it starts with you. What do you say?
Fuck 'em. We got a job to do.
Excellent. New user registered. Welcome to DedSec. Now, it would be irresponsible of us to release you naked and mewling into the wild. You'll find equipment around the safe house that are essential items in your DedSec kit.
And then now we get all the basic tutorial stuff, talking about tech upgrades and gadgets and weapons and all that fun stuff, and then customizing your characters. I always went with the AR cloak, because that definitely helps out first more than anything. Fatma Ali, or Ali Fatma. No, her name's Fatma.
We have a sophisticated system for hiding your identity from facial recognition tech. It's called a mask. And while we're here, perhaps we can talk about updating your wardrobe. I mean, look at you. Come on.
I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to decide what operatives I want, because basically what I did first playthrough was I just went around and essentially collected people and really not even hardly used them, or I would just use them for like disguises and stuff, but I don't know how I'm going to go about recruiting operatives unless
you've
I
got all these fancy new toys, but
pick
it's
like
also important to know the basics.
One
you need to learn
highly
how to throw
really
a punch
good perk and then one really
one
detrimental
Albion
perk.
Will escalate
so
if you come at them with a gun and shoot you down. We want to avoid collateral damage. In DedSec, we tried to use guns only as a last resort.
Have you already met Connie Robinson? She owns the pub and is an old DedSec contact, not to mention a champion amateur boxer. Go to the practice ring and she'll show you how to stop flinching when someone cocks a punch at you.
Yeah, and I'll just right down. Fly right through this fighting tutorial. And I didn't bother to cut out the loading screen just because it's nothing.
Start with some basic strikes. Hit me.
And no, I'm not on the PS5. I was waiting to do this Let's Play on PS5, but I figure the latest I will
you
be getting
get
a PS5 would be
find the weak point.
Nice June, job. Because that's when the Ratchet and Clank game comes out, Rift Apart. That's going to be my first PS5 game unless something else comes along ahead of time, but I don't know. The same thing with Cyberpunk. I feel like if I do decide to get into Cyberpunk, I would get it on PS5. Before I would get it for nice PS4, so. And to be honest, I don't even know when this Let's Play will even start. I'm just recording the first video right now. Because I think 2, by the time I get this out, 2 is long done. I don't know. Depends on how quickly familiar I can get with, again, just recording with a capture card and editing software and stuff.
Right. Gear in order? Know enough not to punch yourself in the face or get shot for pulling out a gun too early? Brilliant. I'm working out how we find Zero Day and ruin their day, but I need someone with actual legs to do the legwork. Hope you're ready.
We have some damage control to do if we want to change the perception that we're a bunch of violent thugs. I'll let you be the judge of how best to handle yourself, but remember, you represent DedSec now.
So that's going to be it for me in this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, make sure to drop a like on this video to stay in tune with the rest of this Let's Play, as well as any of the future content. Make sure to subscribe, hit that bell notification button. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Make no mistake, London is under occupation. Armed mercenaries patrol our streets, allegedly to keep people safe, but really they're keeping the people scared.
Albion is nothing more than a fascist regime installed to scare the people into submission.
So, we have to ignite the will to resist in the people of London by showing them that Albion aren't the solution. They're the problem.
For that, we'll need information. I'm pushing 2 sets of coordinates to your optic.
Cheers, Bagley. I've identified 2 opportunities. 1, we're going to disrupt some Albion propaganda. Remind the people it's not Albion's way or the highway. 2, we need intel about Albion operations if we want to throw a spanner in their plans. You game?
Absolutely. You tell me where and I'll stoke the fire, Sabine.
Brilliant. Let's get the